It is time.
Are you sure it's safe in here?
Oh, come on, I lent that Book of the Dead to Peter and that turned out great.
What are we doing here again?
Help! This horrible demon spirit has kicked me out of my house.
This looks like a job for... someone else.
Oh, come now, we can help him. Where's your home, sir?
It's in this cave somewhere with this golden shit.
Well, that's really... helpful. What does it look like?
It's a freaking lamp with a blue lid.
Oh! You mean like that one over there?
And so the mighty journey ended, because we had no rub animation.
Get the hell out of my house!
Hey, did someone call a djinn?
Peter! Hello, everypony, Stardust here, and today I have with me...
Hey, I'm Thunderboy.
And this is FNGR.
And today, we're going to review Aladdin! Woo!
Woo indeed. Jeez, I still had some youth in me when this came out.
Jeez, how old are you exactly?
Let's see, carry the two. I mean, that's none of your damn business.
Easy, boys. Let's focus on this review here, not who's an old granny, okay?
Well, starting off, what would you like to focus on? The main characters? The music? The plot? The supporting characters?
Aren't you forgetting something? I would assume a changeling of all ponies would...
Understand what? The merchandise behind the movie?
The concept of affection that every being on this godforsaken planet understands. Love.
Oh god, do we really gotta talk about the power of love?
Yes?
This is a Disney movie after all. Let's move on.
Fine, main characters. Jafar is a refreshing change of pace. Despite having the old trope of usurper to the throne, he has a lot of personality, and is even sympathetic for having to work for a bumbling sultan.
Sympathetic, my.
Yay! Such language!
Well, think about it. Did you see the lack of mental capacity the sultan had? Jafar likely had to keep Agrabah from complete squalor.
Yeah. Aside from caring for his daughter a lot, he doesn't seem like a good ruler all that much. But what about Aladdin? Or maybe Jasmine? Those two are fun.
Jasmine? Are we talking about side characters? She was fun when she first showed up, pretending to think that the monkey was a sultan, and after that she kind of fell flat.
Excuse me? Don't call favorite princess a side character or I'll buck you to the moon!
Madam, I have a girlfriend. Oh wait, you said buck.
Alright, that's it!
Genie, guys, don't forget the genie.
Oh yeah, I love the genie. The genie added so much life to the movie. I honestly couldn't see the movie being done without him in it.
Hey. Williams is the best actor since John Floor. Oh wait, future guy. Never mind.
Well, sorry to make everything about ponies, but Genie's kinda like Discord 1.0. Being overpowered, he could easily have eaten up just time and detracted from the plot, but the visuals and the humor just clicked in most of, if not all, the scenes.
That is why he's best character. Ooh, what's this? Guys, wanna go look around and look at this stuff.
Should we also talk about who the movie's mostly focused on? Aladdin. Yes.
Well, by now, Aladdin seems kinda cliche. But Disney Journal, unless I'm mistaken, had good guys with a squeaky clean image. I mean, he's a bum and a thief, and I mean back then, Disney didn't normally do that sort of thing.
I actually like Aladdin, and I love his story too. I love the moments when he's trying to impress Jasmine. He's the first Disney guy, aside from the tramp, who actually goes out and makes an effort to impress the girl he's into. If you look at the rest of the Disney guys, you see them either trying to save the girl, the two just fall in love off the bat, or there's just no effort into impressing the woman. But in this movie, we see Aladdin actually going out and doing what he can to swoon Jasmine. I think that's why he's one of my top favorite Disney male characters.
It was a nice change of pace to not have a neat, polished Ken doll. If you didn't know this is a Disney movie, you might think that there's a fairly good chance. Aladdin might not end up with Jasmine. He's witty, he has good chemistry with his friends, and bounces humor off of Genie really well as Abu.
You know what else was nice? The songs. I loved every one of them. The songs just fit so well with the movie, and the characters were just so animated with the songs that it just made the movie so much fun to watch.
Well, even I can't pretend not remembering the impact the music had in this movie. A Whole New World, Prince Ali, Arabian Nights, and that's just off the top of my head. They're happy, they invoke emotions, they're not good animated songs, they're good songs, period.
I don't think there was a single song in this movie that didn't fit well with the story or the movie itself. They were all just so amazing.
You guys are going to talk about Howard Ashman, right?
Sweetie, how did you...
Of course we're talking about Howard Ashman? He's the director, right?
Amateurs.
But they're not in the script.
Howard Ashman was a master lyricist behind many of Alan Menken's early work in Disney. Menken Ashman was the new Sherman Brothers. They were the dynamic duo behind The Little Mermaid and Beauty and the Beast, just to name the top gems. During the making of The Little Mermaid, however, he was diagnosed with AIDS. He struggled through the making of Beauty and the Beast, but sadly, despite putting his heart into many of the songs, he was not able to make it through the production of Aladdin. Every song in this movie is his, save for one. Tim Rice jumped on the team to finish off the last song, which, ironically, was the most successful song in the movie, A Whole New World. This movie was the last impact Howard was able to make on the world, and we will always remember him for it.
I suddenly feel like I'm watching the video instead of being in one. There's a whole new appreciation for this work I didn't even know about.
But the script, but my video.
Ouch, you got bushwhacked by a pink pony.
Shh, it's okay.
Alright then. I think we can move on now. What's next? Oh, right, the plot. Is she gonna be in here for the rest of the video?
Well, I did summon her with dark magic. There's no telling how that'll turn out. I think we touched on most of these things already. Is there a deeper meaning you want to pull out of Genie's struggle for freedom?
Yes. In the movie, we also get to see what the Genie wants from life. He wants to be free, but no one has ever actually given him the opportunity to be free. Here, someone actually asked him what he wants, and he feels honored at first, but he pushes that aside because he doubts it'll ever happen. We also see him get hurt because he was promised freedom, the one thing he longed for, and then he had his own dreams crushed. Can you just imagine how that feels? A dream that you've had your whole life, then someone comes up and offers to have that dream come true, you get so excited, and then boom, that chant just blows up and you're back to where you were. Cinderella had that feel to it as well, but here it felt more emotional and heartbreaking because of how the stories played out and how the characters impacted one another.
I think that's why people think of Genie as the main character. He has more at stake. Aladdin's concern for the most part is about getting the girl. Outwardly, he wishes for riches because he needs them to get Jasmine. Genie has his freedom on the line. It's a new twist of having ultimate power but not the will to use it. Come to think of it, Jafar's issue kinda mirrors Genie's. He has a great deal of power and or influence, but he can't at least outwardly display it. Come to think of it, all the main characters are awash in deception. Aladdin to Jasmine, Jafar to the Sultan, Jasmine to her father. I guess Genie's character is the only forthcoming character. The magical trickster, the non-human, is the voice of honesty.
That is true. Well, would you mind talking about one more thing?
Oh, that's right, the sub-characters. We could talk about the parrot. Or the monkey.
Did somebody say monkeys?
No! You don't have to damage my video. Let me do things with the stuff just the one time.
So Iago is a refreshing look at sidekicks?
That's not exactly what I meant. I want to talk about the Louvre. You know, your favorite.
Fine. Abu and Aladdin have a bromance that makes up.
No, bad. You go sit in the lamp with Peter.
Ooh, visitors.
Fine, there's a princess, a boy. Boy gets money, boy gets girl. The end. Roll credits.
You're supposed to be in the lamp. Get out of here. Now as I... Not a single word from you. Got it?
Meow?
I'll take that as a yes. So anyways, the relationship between Aladdin and Jasmine is quite interesting here. It has its good moments as well as its eh moments. First interaction we get with the two, we see them sharing similar dreams, and they just want to break out of the life that they're living. Later, we see them spending more time together and Aladdin making efforts to impress Jasmine. Now here's where it gets kind of interesting. Usually in Disney princess movies, if a prince comes up and is all good looking with riches and so on, the princess, or the girl, would go for him in a heartbeat, but instead, Jasmine doesn't really want to know him because she's had too many people trying to impress her with that sort of thing. But once Aladdin and Jasmine get another opportunity to just talk about who they are, Jasmine did start to open up to him more because she finally actually got an opportunity to talk to someone like an actual human being. Then when we get closer to the end of the movie, she does kind of fall hard in love with him. And I do like the two, I just wish we got to see more of their relationship grow throughout the movie.
Is it safe to come out now? What I saw was a movie that ran out of time to fit a proper love story in, whatever that is. And instead of Aladdin winning Jasmine's heart, he essentially saves the world, or rather, her world. The message is, boys, if you can shift the powers cosmic, you too can get the girl, even if you lie, cheat, and steal. Come to think of it, good on you, Disney.
Is that it?
Yep. So till next time...
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Wrapping up the video. It's how I do it on my channel.
This isn't your channel!
Fine, carry on.
Thank you. What did you guys think about the movie? Leave your thoughts and-
Leave a comment and I will see you later. Brony on, my friends.
What? No! This was my video!
It turns out that it was his lamp after all. This is what I came in with. Now end the video right away before someone else ruins it.
I would like to take a moment and honor someone who we all loved as an actor who has recently passed. For not him, this movie, as well as many others, could not have been brought to life. He has brought so much laughter and joy to many. He will be greatly missed. May he rest in peace, Robin Williams.